I will use three words: personalized, multi-modal, universal for Rakuten services.
What does it mean to me as a user?
One of my colleagues recently, I want to buy a pillow. By using the Rakuten AI Assistant, he's able to.
Guangda Li is driving AI innovation at Rakuten's Singapore lab. His work is transforming our interaction with AI, making it more personal, practical, and universally accessible.
What can Rakuten AI Assistant do for society?
One of the functions, in fact, inside Rakuten AI Assistant is we are not only trying to sell you products, we are also trying to provide.
Hi, Guangda. How are you tonight?
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, thank you.
Thanks for being here with us and talking about everything you know about the Rakuten AI Assistant. Can you please tell us a little bit about what makes it so unique?
I will use three words: personalized and multimodal and also universal for Rakuten services. For example, last year, I want to go to Hokkaido. This is my first time, right, to go to Hokkaido. I need to check the weather. I need to know where to book the hotel. I need to prepare which other things I need to buy, right? So there are so many things I need to do, and I need to do a lot of online search and also go to different websites to buy things. Rakuten AI Assistant happen to be type of like a services able to provide those kind of solutions for this kind of need.
Excellent. And can you share another example where a consumer was really empowered by the work that you and your team are doing?
One of my colleagues recently, I want to buy a pillow. He doesn't really speak or read Japanese, but he want to buy that on Ichiba, right? Because there's so many choices, right? So he can choose from. So for Rakuten AI Assistant, we provide not only Japanese interfaces, we also provide English interface. Right, so by using the Rakuten AI Assistant, he's able to find the pillow he wants because there are so many choices. And we use large language model to help him to understand what he needs and also connect him with the right pillow in Ichiba, and he make that purchase. He had the pillow yesterday. Yeah.
In terms of future developments, what are you and the team working on that you can share with us?
There are so many different services in Rakuten Group, right? At the moment, we only enable the integration with a few of them. Definitely, we want to integrate with more services. And also, at the same time, we want to provide a certain platform for different services can try out this type of native AI experience we are trying to develop. At the same time, we can benefit from their developments and also help the consumer to have this one entry point to test out different Rakuten services. This is what I call that go wider, right? So for go deeper, I think our key next step is really try to enable these personalizations, right? Super personalizations. So when you're doing the chat function with the Rakuten AI Assistant, the application is already able to memorize your recent chat, right? So, but it's only short terms. We want to enable long terms, especially connect with the past data you have been interact with all the other Rakuten services, and then we are able to provide more tailored, like advice or products or services to you. That's what we call that go deeper.
Super personalization. What is that? And what does it mean to me as a user?
We all have a different preferences, right? A different preference for like a price. All these kind of elements could be personalized. So the services are already able to provide this kind of personalization functionality. However, for super personalization, I think when you open the app, you already get what you need. You already think a few steps ahead of you, right? We quietly and also analyze, you know, what you need. I think that's kind of like a super personalization I'm referring to.
If you could just explain what types of issues or let's say problems do you think that we as Rakuten are going to be able to solve?
One interesting angle we are trying to look at is there are many applications Rakuten developed over years. And for a new user of one of the Rakuten service, they may not really know the other services Of course, we develop the very, very attractive super points programs to attract users to explore more services. Take some time to user to try from one application to two, to three, to four, to maybe 20, right? And if we are able to leverage on the capability of a large language model to really understand user's intention, then we don't need the user to download like a 20 app. And then, you know, they can get their need solved in these interfaces. That's kind of like a vision we have.
If you were to summarize what Rakuten AI Assistant can do for society at large, do you have any ideas?
One of the functions, in fact, inside Rakuten AI Assistant is companionships. So we are not only trying to sell you products. We are also trying to provide some suggestions. And that's why if you look at a lot of chat applications these days, companionships actually is the key, you know, point people keep using it. So for us, we want to combine all these kind of elements together, right? So when you have a shopping need, when you want to like explore other Rakuten services, we are also able to help that. That's kind of a vision I have. And I hope this is useful for society as well.
Thank you for sharing all your knowledge about the Rakuten AI Assistant, and thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.